Hang on, just checking my emails. Just kidding. But it is a problem these days, isn't it? You know, how much time we spend on our phones and how much we depend on them. So today I'm going to ditch the phone and I'm going to tell you how you can bring modern technology to traditional pieces of art. So your cabinet could tell you when someone's at the door, and a painting could tell you when you've got a message. That'll be Cam Diggity. A watering can could tell you when your plants are thirsty. A Nefertari could tell you whether the weather tomorrow is going to be as wet as the Nile or as hot as the Sahara. But most importantly, today I'd like to introduce you to a special friend of mine and show you how I made him and how you can use the same principles to bring your own ornaments to life. But first, let's talk about the problem. Stop what you're doing and look at your phone. Now look at your PC and your TV and your Alexa, your Xbox, look at any device. They're all the same, aren't they? They're flat slabs of plastic and glass, featureless and sterile. By design, they're minimalist, homogeneous devices. Hundreds of millions of people around the world right now are clutching an identical device to you. Even the devices that are different look the same. Does the iPhone really look fundamentally different to a Galaxy or a Pixel? Really? They are designed to be sterile in their appearance. They're soulless. They almost want to disappear. That's why they've become smaller and smaller, less bumps, less grooves, shrinking bezels. Now, look at a wooden table, an ornament. A plank of wood, a flipping rock. Can you feel it? It's different, isn't it? The waves, the curves, the bumps and grooves tell stories and intrigue your interest. They're beautiful. And more than this, they're unique. But here's the conundrum. Crafted items exude beauty, but they're inert. They sit on a shelf, and we admire them for a bit, but then they start to fade, and before we know it, they've literally become part of the furniture. And this is how our brains work. We're wired from primeval times to spot change, to see that movement in the grass and hear the growl in the dark. Our brains work furiously to noise cancel everything else. So, static art without function will inevitably fade into the background. On the other hand, technology devices may be soulless, but they are full of value. They buzz and whir and ping information at us constantly, and they've been designed from the ground up to grab our attention with the lights and the sounds and the alerts, which is why we can't put them down. So, do we have to live with this divide? Are we doomed to spend 10 hours plus a day staring at a minimalist sterile chunks of plastic glass and ignore the beautiful items in our home? What if there was a better way? What if you could inject life into the everyday objects that we forget? What if we could break ourselves free of devices piece by piece? And all this whilst bringing crafted items to life. Now that sounds like something quite magical, like dragons. Meet David. I fell in love with David as soon as I saw him glistening in a corner of the old shop at Conwy Castle. Now Conwy is a beautiful castle town in North Wales, and it's a proper castle built in 1283. It's a pretty magical place. And David was just sitting glistening in the corner, so intricate and delicate. His design echoes the Welsh national flag and thus thousands of years of history. Rhynnu yma o hyd. But although he was stunning, I knew that in that moment what would happen. I'd buy him, I would put him on a shelf and marvel at him for a while, but gradually I'd get used to him and then ultimately forget about him. At the same time, I'd also had solar panels and batteries installed in our house. So I was fascinated by all the data. And so I was looking at the app dozens of times a day to check generation and battery levels and household energy use and more. And this wasn't just frivolous app addiction, because understanding and tuning this has saved me thousands of pounds. So again, we had this pattern, a soulless device with masses of information streaming out of it, and an absolutely beautiful device that was inert. And that is when I thought, what if I could bring David the Dragon to life? Let me introduce you to Data David. He is a fully smart-enabled home automation device that can convey basically any information you want from any device on Earth. You want to know when your plants need watering? David can tell you. You want to know what the weather is like this week? He knows. He can boogie to the music, fade with the sunlight, and ripple with the temperature of the room. He's alive. So, whilst I've got him configured to tell me the precise conditions of my solar setup, you could use the same technique for almost any device to power any ornament. So let me walk you through how I made this Franken-Dragon. Okay, I'm not going to go through all the nitty-gritty here. However, I do want to give you a quick tour. I've got a full tutorial on my site if you want more details. So this is more about demonstrating how you can integrate technology into your art, rather than slavishly copying what I've done. Nonetheless, I used a few simple components which I'll list in the description. I'll also link to my site where you can download all the parts like the diffuser and the ESP chip enclosure if that's useful to you. I guess a key point here is how cheaply this can be done. All the software is free. The LEDs start from pennies per LED to however complex you want it to be. And the chip itself was about £5, and the cases cost pennies to print as well. Okay, let me explain how it works and the secret language of my dragon. If I just dismantle this carefully, what I settled on was this. Now, it might be a little hard to make out on the camera because LEDs struggle a bit in the camera, but I can assure you it's super clear in real life. This says more about my ability to use a camera than my poor dragon. Anyway, the outer ring shows my home battery charge amount. So a complete circle means it's 100% charged. And as you can see, it's almost there today. So I need to put a wash on. But half a circle would mean a 50% battery level, and a quarter is 25%, and so on. Really easy and quick to read. The next circle inside that, this green layer, is where I've taken a sample of my minimum and maximum weekly energy use and used that to create a percentage calculation just like the outer ring. So a full ring means heavy energy use, an empty ring means very low energy use, and everything in between. And you can see today we're using just over half what our maximum is. Finally, the main effect in the centre of the circle shows the solar generation. The volume, intensity, and speed of the glowing effect changes to reflect the real-time solar generation. So at night time, it's completely dark. On a grey day, it embers away. And on a bright sunny day like today, you can see the dragon is sparkling and flaming vigorously. Putting this together, it means I can really quickly see, at a glance, all my core settings. You know, I could naturally add a third and a fourth or a fifth ring if I wanted, but three pieces of data is a good number and allows me to really quickly understand everything. Now, let me tour you through the hardware to see how all this comes together. The main functionality here is the addressable LED ring light, because this allows me to individually light and colour any one of 172 LEDs to reflect various conditions. I covered this with a nice translucent 3D printed diffuser to stop the LEDs being too sharp on the eye. And this is all sitting in a custom walnut base that I carved using the CNC. Then I finally just had to carefully position the dragon and add the cloche, which just protects it from any naughty children who might be playing football in the house. This is all powered by a microcontroller like this that lives inside this 3D printed enclosure. And that does all the translation of data to lights. This is running some cool software called WLED that I'll cover in a bit. But in short, it converts the data from Home Assistant into LED signals to light up the relevant LEDs, change their color and more. So you'll see I can easily click a button and can get it to display pretty much any effect that I can dream of. So let's give that a go. I'll just try this one. This is called bouncing balls. So you could maybe use that to signal how many emails you've got in your inbox. We've got BPM here. So that could beat in time to the music when it's on. And then I'll just try this one. This is called Candy Cane. So, you know, this could tell you when you've got a missed call, for example. Oh, the mind is already whirring with ideas. But there are seriously hundreds of different effects that you can do just at the click of a button. I could be here all day showing you. But instead, let's look at the software that's powering this, which is really where the magic happens. There's three bits of completely free software that will change your life in projects like this. Firstly, Home Assistant. I've already got Home Assistant running in my house. And if you haven't got this, then get it sorted right now because it is one of the seven wonders of the modern maker world. And it unlocks so much cool stuff, it really needs an entire video to cover it. Having this installed means it's super easy to stream data from my solar panels, inverter and batteries. I have a Give Energy inverter, so I use the relevant integration to build it into Home Assistant. And this will obviously naturally vary based on your own setup, but it's fundamentally the same simple process. Secondly, WLED, which is another wonder of the maker world. And this is a super cool software that lets you program and animate individually controllable LEDs. And finally, ESPHome. I'm using the wonderful ESPHome to program the chip. And now that Home Assistant has done the heavy lifting, it's super simple to program. It just needs a few lines of code to stream the data to the right pins on the ESP chip, which will then trigger the relevant WLED patterns. So David now lives on my piano in the hall of the house, and I look at him all the time as he twinkles away, whispering his little signals to me. What's brilliant and what I didn't expect is how efficient it is compared to a phone. I can read all of my solar settings at a glance and I'd barely be able to take my phone out in the same time, let alone unlock it and open the app and wait for it to connect and flick through all of the three pages that I need. Plus, I've taken away all of those gormless moments of phone staring. David, meanwhile, as a piece of art, is even more beautiful to me than he would have been. The lights sparkle on every curve of glass. I mean, seriously, this is created from blown glass. He's a truly beautiful piece of art, and I'm really glad that I've been able to enhance that beauty. Finally, this is smart art that evolves. All of the free software that I mentioned have huge ecosystems of brilliant developers who are updating, enhancing, evolving the capabilities every day. So David will also evolve in the years to come when I finally replace my aging solar system with the home fusion reactor I've always wanted. Then I can convert David to tell me how many gigawatts I'm generating with just a couple of clicks. This sort of fusion of technology and art really makes me buzz with excitement. Everywhere I look, I can see opportunities to apply this. And if you've watched my other videos, you'll know that this is what I've been doing in my custom PC case series. The next steps of that series will be for me to create a PC case made of beautiful walnut. If only the darn new CNC will get shipped. I'm still waiting, so if anyone lives in Illinois, let me know and I'll pay you to shout through the megaphone at certain CNC manufacturer. There's also loads of cool stuff that I'm going to be doing to bring this sort of tech into my workshop, my dressing room, this study, and the whole place is going to be a menagerie of living tech crafts. So watch out, the future's coming.